Hi, my name is Harry, and today I'm going to be talking about the External Memory Interface Device Selector. I'm going to be giving an introduction and tutorial on the Device Selector. A little bit about me, I'm currently in the rotation program here at Intel FPGA, and I rotated through the External Memory Interface Factory Applications Engineering team, and there I worked extensively on the Device Selector. Let's begin. Why do you need a Device Selector? Well, there's these things called I/O columns inside the FPGA, and they're made up of I/O banks. And to connect things such as the external memory interface or transceivers, you need these I/O banks, and they are limited inside these I/O columns inside the FPGA. So our Device Selector tool allows you to see how many banks your configuration of external memory interfaces uses, which is extremely invaluable in designing your end application. Another factor might be interface bandwidth. Interface bandwidth is something that could be a factor in case you want to achieve a certain bandwidth, so you want to know what kind of configuration you need to achieve that certain bandwidth. Or if you already know what kind of memory interface configuration you want, you can see how much bandwidth it can achieve, theoretically, of course. Another factor might be estimating if a configuration is even possible within a certain device family. Things that are possible in the Stratix device family might not be possible in the ARIA device family. So using the Device Selector tool, you can choose a configuration and you can find the certain number of devices that fit your configuration specifically. There's several points within the Device Selector tool that I want to hit upon. The Device Selector tool GUI itself has parameters that you can adjust, such as protocol, interface width, memory format, etc. You can also add multiple interfaces from 1 to 15 interfaces and adjust those specific parameters within each interface accordingly. There's also support for dynamic bandwidth update, so you can actually see how much bandwidth your interfaces can achieve, whether you have one interface or four interfaces, and the combined bandwidth that those four interfaces give you. We've also added something new called the bandwidth tool. The bandwidth tool links with the Device Selector tool, and it takes three parameters. It takes bandwidth in gigabits per second, it takes protocol, and it also takes efficiency. It uses those three parameters to calculate a certain interface configuration for you, so you don't have to do anything in filling in the Device Selector tool GUI. It populates it for you, and from there, you can click Find Devices to see what devices match the bandwidth that you want to achieve. I'll go more into detail about this tool in the coming slides. There's a couple reasons why we added a bandwidth tool to the Device Selector. One reason is to decide on the memory interface configuration with far less parameters. You'll see later that in the bandwidth tool, there's only three parameters, two of which you need to enter and one of which is defaulted to already. There's the bandwidth that the user needs to enter, the protocol, and the efficiency of your interface. So the bandwidth tool only takes three parameters and gives you a slew of configurations that you can find your device with. Another factor is to estimate based on a certain bandwidth requirement from the user. If you want to hit, let's say, 200 gigabits per second, you can enter that number in and it'll automatically populate a configuration within the Device Selector GUI for you that hits that bandwidth. And it'll actually tell you the exact number using the algorithm within the bandwidth tool to tell you how much gigabits per second your specific interface configuration can hit. As you can see, we've listed the algorithm out here on the slide for you. Bandwidth in gigabits per second equals this equation as follows. You can pause the video here to take a look at the equation. As you can see, upon opening the EMIF Device Selector, you can see a few buttons on the left-hand side. You have Device Selector Tool, Bandwidth Tool, Design Guidelines, and User Guide. You'll need macros for this tool to work, so enable macros. Let's start with the Device Selector Tool. The Device Selector currently supports Stratix 10 or ARIA 10 devices. When you click the button, this window pops up. As you can see, it supports multiple amount of interfaces. It has a dynamic bandwidth window. You can select which family you want to use, and all the parameters are easily configurable here. Let's do a test run. Let's select three memory interfaces, all DDR4. Let's change one to 64 bits and change the other to 48. Let's keep everything else as is except for the interface speed. Let's put that up to 1200. And the percentage, this matters when you want to look at the dynamically updated bandwidth. So let's set that to 70% for each interface. When the red light is on here, that means the bandwidth in this window isn't the newest updated bandwidth. When you click the Update Bandwidth button here, this light will turn from red to green, indicating that the bandwidth shown here is the newest updated bandwidth based on the parameters you've adjusted. I'll go ahead and do that now. As you can see, the interface configuration we have here, based on three DDR4 interfaces, hits 309.12 gigabits per second. Let's see if that matches up to a device with our device selector tool. We'll go ahead and click on Find Devices. So you can see the devices listed here, and you can see the number of I/O banks required for each interface. We'll scroll down here, and for Stratix 10, all these devices are able to fit the configuration that we've listed. So that's the device selector route. So we just saw the device selector tool in action. But what if we don't know what configuration we want, or we want to use a certain bandwidth number to set our memory interface configuration? That's where the bandwidth tool comes into play. Let's go ahead and go to the left and click on Bandwidth Tool. As you can see, the Bandwidth Tool window pops up, and there's three parameters that you can fill out: bandwidth in gigabits per second, memory protocol, and efficiency, which already defaults to 70%. Let's go ahead and fill out these parameters now. I'll go with 250 gigabits per second, and we'll go with the DDR3 interface this time, DDR3 protocol. Let's go ahead and hit enter. And as you can see, it ports in the DDR3 protocol. It decides the width for you based on the bandwidth you've entered, and tries to match the bandwidth as closely as it can with the parameters that you've entered into the previous tool. Keep in mind, you're only using three parameters: the protocol, the bandwidth, and also the percentage. And that, based on that, it can calculate the width that you need and decide how many interfaces you need for your end application. Let's go ahead and click Find Devices, and let's go with the ARIA 10 this time. As you can see, there's 2.5 I/O banks required for each interface, and these ARIA 10 devices are fitting for the design that you're trying to achieve. That was the bandwidth tool. So we've seen the device selector tool and the bandwidth tool in action. You might notice two other buttons on the side: design guidelines and user guide. Design guidelines point you to the specific EMIF design guidelines for each device family. When you get the EMIF device selector tool, you can go ahead and click through to those sections for more information. The user guide takes you to an online wiki for the EMIF device selector tool itself. I'll go ahead and show you the wiki page. It's a wiki format with more description of parameters, windows, and a process in how you can use the tool. The latest version of the device selector tool is also available online here. That was the external memory interface Device Selector Introduction and Tutorial. My name is Harry, and on behalf of Intel FPGA, thank you for watching.